Hi.
Hallo.
Hi.
Hello.
Is there my sound quality good?
Yeah, sounds good to me.
Great. So, hello everybody. Shuban is still in recovery mode and he asked me to take the small part of the moderation for this week's biweekly engineering meeting where we talk about finished, ongoing, and planned development and roadmap tasks. Should we wait a little bit longer if more people will join? But I think we are already a lot, right? So let me share the screen. Let's today go over the current agenda items and afterwards see if there are more topics where people want to talk about. And with this, let's start with the 5G updates, I think from Baljit, right?
Yes, Nils. Good morning, all. Good evening. So today we have a short status from Wavelab side. Wavelab team for 5G SA basically very much working on feature testing and continued unit testing, CA testing, and performance testing. So far, it's going well with 1.8. We are not seeing any major blockers. And when it comes to the I shared some GenHab tasks close there. The first one is this is related to registration issue where missing contact setup IE was not present and the issue is fixed. And there are another set of three peers got merged. First one is related to pipeline D for 1.8 production changes. And the next one, the 13624 is it's a very much documentation peer for 5G SA features. It got merged. And then we have a 13318 is just another issue, defect got fixed. Other than that, the team is very much working. There are a few items came up from 1.8 release meeting, which our Wavelab team is working on, mainly tied up with deployment of AGW end-to-end testing, some orchestrated testing, and 5G SA feature testing. Thus, continue work from the team. And plus, there's ongoing Spiren testing and the unit testing with ABOT from Ravika. That's ongoing. From pending peer, mainly there's a documentation peer and the support work team is doing. And release notes is one of them we are working on. This is very much I have today, Nils.
Okay, thank you very much, Dajit. Are there any questions or comments? Then let's head over to the next block. A couple of Bazel updates. First one is Lars with Dictionary of Make versus Bazel commands. And yes, I guess you want to take over the screen, right?
Yeah, that would be great. Yeah. Thanks. I want to first talk about this point here. So this is there were some cleanup efforts that we did. We removed a lot of unused and unnecessary make commands. Some were really outdated and broken. Overall, we removed about 2,000 lines of code from make and related files. And in this effort, we also, in preparation for the Bazel switchover for AGW, we created a sort of dictionary. So on this wiki page, and this is still a work in progress, but here you can see all the make commands that are relevant for AGW. So this is from the LTE gateway make file, but you can also go to the Python make file or the intertest make file. And then you see here what is the equivalent command on the Bazel side. So for like running all the tests here, then you can just run the Python unit test and so on. So feel free to sort of go through this list and familiarize yourself with all the different targets that we have. So we already cover all AGW related make targets with the exception of the formatters and linters. They are not yet covered. Everything else you should be able to do in make in Bazel. But of course, you have to be careful with new mix them sort of. So if you build like SCTPD with Bazel, then you won't be able to use the artifact with make just because they are different folders. So you have to be somewhat careful with that right now. And then there are some make targets like these service commands here, and they are not really make target sort of, so they're just aliasing these commands. And for this, we have an PR that is open right now. You can see it here. And there was also a discussion on Slack about how this should be done. And this PR would create aliases in the Magma Dev and Magma Debian VMs. So you could just type Magma start, stop, restart, and status to get the same behavior as with the make commands, but you could use it in any folder, so you don't have to be where the make file is. So this is sort of one advantage. And yeah, in this PR, we then also clean up all this make usage of these, which also is quite a bit of code that was just lying around in different make files. Yeah, so if you have any feedback on this, on these commands or the mechanism or on the Bazel make dictionary, feel free to ask now or in the Bazel's Slack thread or channel. Yeah. Are there any questions for this?
I just noticed something. If you go back to the dictionary, yeah. I think make run is by far the most used of these commands, and the Bazel equivalent seems lengthy. Might be good for there too.
Yeah, so right now we're just aliasing, or at least what SPR is doing is just aliasing these service commands. How we deal with these longer Bazel commands is still open, but yeah, it would make sense to have like build all services and so on as a convenient alias, but that's up for discussion on how that should be handled exactly and what aliases are needed. But yeah, for something like make run, it would sort of make sense to have something convenient. I agree. And yeah, this is sort of also a disclaimer up here. So this is still a work in progress, and yeah, there will be potentially more aliases created. And if anyone has any particular command that they feel is very cumbersome or that they use a lot or some other comments about this, yeah, feel free.
Thank you. Are there more comments or questions? Then let's jump over to Chris.
Actually, I have one comment. It would be useful to have this dictionary in the wiki for looking up later on.
Yeah, that's exactly where it is. So if you look at the just here again.
It was in an issue.
No, this is in the Magma wiki. So the page is called Bazel Make Commands Dictionary.
If it's first thing in the morning here in California, pardon me.
No worries. And yeah, I put the link on the page here for the meeting, so you can also click on here.
Thank you.
Okay, then I will continue with some updates on the sudo test with Bazel. Now the AT intact test Bazel workflow is running the sudo tests that were built with Bazel. And now we have a nice summary at the end of the workflow. It's now a separate step. And there is also an XML file generated. This is just an example of the XML file. And if you want to execute the sudo test with Bazel, you should use this run sudo test.sh script. With the help function, you can see some new functionalities. Now you can list all of the sudo tests, and there is this retry on failure option, which you can specify and then give the number of retry attempts. This is on a per test basis, and this will retry your test if it fails for the first time or second time, depends on how many retries you want. And that is all for the sudo tests with Bazel. Are there any questions?
Doesn't seem so. Then, thank you very much, Lars and Chris. Next one is then Sebastian with an update for the Python dependency upgrades.
Yeah, so hi everyone. It's a short update. I think we talked about it 4 weeks ago or so, that we were planning to upgrade the Python dependencies that could be easily upgraded. It hasn't been done in a while. And this is finally merged, and it's surprisingly difficult to test. That's why it took a while. So I'll talk a bit about the problems. It's basically in the way Magma is distributed. So we create a Debian package for Magma, and then also Debian packages for each of these Python dependencies. And the build toolchain contains a very complicated script called PyDeb that packages all these third-party dependencies into Debian packages. And when we did all the upgrades, we had to manually test that the script still works and is still able to create packages for all updated dependencies. The problem is that it cannot handle certain types of Python libraries, so this is blocking some upgrades. And despite these tests, when we finally merged it, we actually broke master for around 2 days, and it took a while to fix, because the script has another complication. After you merge the script, it uploads the changed libraries to the Artifactory, and the Artifactory itself is an input of this of this build tool. So if you change the state of the Artifactory, then the behavior of the build tool changes again. In this case, it caused a bug and broke master for 1, 2, 3 days, I'm not sure. But this is finally fixed, and now the libraries are upgraded and it's green again. And the question is how to handle this build tool chain in the future. And we actually hope that this problem will be solved by two things. One is the containerized gateway, which no longer makes the Debian toolchain necessary. And the other one is Bazel, which is able to build a Debian package without using this complicated script. And hopefully for future releases, we will be able to get rid of the script and build it in another way that will make upgrades much easier. And that's it for the Python upgrades. Any questions?
Not a question, but a comment. By the master issue, it on the bright side, it was discovered that the same failures happened on the 1.8 release branch. And this uncovered that there were some configurations missing that needed to be done for the release. Okay, I will quickly share my screen again, but only to show you that we are finished with the official agenda. Maybe for DevOps, anybody here who wants to give a DevOps related update on something? Anything interesting for the release? Are there any updates? Ben, is there anyone who wants to talk about a topic that is not on the agenda? Okay, I gave my best, but it seems everybody is happy. So then I think this was a quick meeting, which is always a good meeting. So have a nice day, have a nice evening, and see you in 2 weeks. Bye-bye.
Bye. Thanks, bye.